Welcome to the Lightspeed Restaurant Getting Started video guide for K-Series. I'm Vinny, here to help you build your menus and the items that populate them. The individual products you sell in your restaurant are called items in K-Series. And those items can be grouped together into menus in your POS. For example, if you run a supper menu, you'll need to create an item for each main dish, side, and drink available, and then add them to the supper menu. Let's get to building your first menu. To do that, we'll need to start by creating the items that make up your menu. Sign into the back office, and in the sidebar, click Menu Management, and then Items. You can use the Create button to create a single item, multiple items, an item group, or a combo. Items are individual products, like a burger, a pizza slice, or a sandwich. They can be assigned names, prices, and more. Item groups are sets of items where customers choose one or more options. For instance, a side dish group might consist of fries, onion rings, and salad. Combos are sets of items sold together at a fixed price. Great for meal deals or packages. You might have a combo with a burger, a side, and a medium drink. Menus are the way Lightspeed Restaurant organizes the items into screens on the POS software. You can organize different menus according to your needs. For instance, you might have very different menus available for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Menus are composed of two things, screens and buttons. Screens organize your items into categories. So for a screen called burgers, you could have a selection of items called hamburger, cheeseburger, and vegetarian, each of which would have its own button. Buttons can represent items, but also groups of items. So on a screen called tea, you might have a list of teas that are available, but also a button called additions. Tapping on additions in the POS then opens up a group of items where you could select sugar, honey, milk, oat milk, and/or lemon. Now let's create some items and build a menu. If you were previously using a different POS system, you can export your menu to a file and import it into Lightspeed Restaurant. We've got a link in the description below that will go into the details. But the simplest way to manually enter many items is by using the manual import option of Import Items. On the Items screen, click the Create button and then the Multiple Items option. Simply add the information like name, price, and accounting group using one line per item. There are other fields like Statistic Group and Screen that are optional, so we can leave those blank for now. Click the Add button to add each one to the list. You also need to assign an accounting group to each new item. This is useful for grouping similar things together when applying taxes, generating reports, or comparing sales. You can use the default accounting groups provided by BackOffice or create your own as you add the items. To add new ones, switch the toggle called Create New Accounting Groups from off to on. For this example, we'll add a hamburger with a price of $10 in the accounting group of food. Using the same process as before, let's add two other types of burger, cheeseburger and vegetarian, also with the price of $10 in the same accounting group. Once you're done adding items, click Import to submit your list and complete the process. You can add a lot more information to each item, like allergy info, production instructions, barcodes, ingredients, inventory tracking, and more by editing each item. All of the details can be found on our Lightspeed Restaurant Help Center, but for now, this should be enough to get you started. And that's it! Now we're ready to add these items to our menu. In the sidebar under Menu Management, click Menus. There's a default menu available which you can edit simply by clicking on it. But let's walk through creating a brand new menu called Supper. From here, we want to add a screen called Burgers for our burger options. Now that we've got a screen, let's add some buttons, one for each type of burger we offer. Click the Add button, then Item. In the pop-up, we see a list of the burgers we just created available. Click the checkboxes next to the three types of burger and click Add Buttons. If you want to see what this will look like on your POS, click Preview and you'll see a screen for burgers with a button for each type of burger that we've added. Any changes you make to screens here will be saved automatically in the back office system. The next time your POS hardware syncs to the back office, the changes will be reflected there too, if the menu is assigned to a POS configuration. We'll talk more about linking and configuring your POS devices in another video. And that's it, you're on your way with items and menus. If you have any questions, just visit our K-Series Help Center or visit any of the links in the description.